Today, we're going to talk about layouts. Layouts is a really powerful tool where you can select all your fixtures individually if you want to. You can build the layout view exactly as you want it. It's completely customizable. You can change colors, you can change fixtures, you can change appearances, you can add groups, you can add all kinds of different things. So in this tutorial, we're going to build what you see on the screen right now. It's very simple. It doesn't take very long. So keep watching and I'll show you how it works. We are starting right here where we left off the last time when we built all our presets using all the swipey commands. You know this view, and if you haven't seen that episode, you can go back and watch episode 5. It's about presets and using the swipey commands. Right now, we need to close this window down or clear this window and open another one to our layout view. Before we start, we need to clear the screen. And if you remember how to do that, we go up to the little icon up here. We press it and we say delete this screen. Now the screen is black. We need to find the layout view. The layout view consists of two different things. The layout view itself and some selection tools next to it. So if we start with opening the layout view here, you go in under common and you press the layout view. This opens up the layout in a full window. We need to scale it a little bit down because we need the room for something else. Over here in the side, we can maybe make it a little bit bigger. We press the square up here and we go into pools and we find the layouts over here. We need the layout pool over here because we can filter down what's in the layout view. But first of all, we need to build the rest. Right down here, we need to save our groups or open our group window. We do that under the pools command and we find the groups. And there you can see this is the groups we stored the last time. We can scale it down all the way down because we only need these four. Right next to the group, we need our sequences open. So we open the pools and we go down and we find the sequences. I just stored a few ones here so we can see the layout view in action. So this is basically the view we need. We can extend this further. We can use it with macros. We can do all kinds of stuff. I just wanted to explain to you the simplest way to do a layout view. So we store this view. We can go up here into the command section. We can press store and we can store the view over here. So right now we have stored our view. We'll just call it layout. Layout. There we go. Right now we see nothing. If you worked on the GrandMA3, you know that you would choose your fixtures and you would store and merge them into your layout view. You would actually store it into these groups over here. On the GrandMA3, this has changed you up just a little bit. Now you assign your fixtures into your layout view. So what we can do first is choose all our Vipers. We do it like this. We say Alt plus A, which is our assign key, if you have your shortcuts turned on. Now we have all our Vipers, we say assign, and we just push the screen up here. That assigns all the fixtures, all the Mac Vipers into our layout view. We can zoom in just a little bit and we can go into the setup menu over here. In the setup menu, you have the option of moving things around. You can add stuff, you can delete stuff. Let's just try to do that. So let's just clear out of this one and we say the arrow up here and we say number one. We need to move it. We take this one. This is the move command. We can just move it wherever we want it. And we just move it up here. It's snapping is on right now. If snapping is not on, you go into this command in here. And you can see all the different options you have in here. Snap to grid, it's much easier to work with. I think it's much easier to work with. But whatever makes you happy, you can do whatever. So you basically just move them around until they are positioned the way you like it. Now all our Vipers are lined up the way we want it. Let's do the same with our Auras. I'm just going to speed this one up just a little bit so you don't have to wait for me finishing it. We stored all our Vipers. We stored all our Auras. Let's do the same for the Atomics, but let's just do it in a different way. We assign the Atomics like we usually do. Then we place it here in the center between number 6 and number 7. There's 12 in total. And then we do like we did in the 3D view. We align them. We take the dash right here and we turn the dial. And then we can position it like this as well. So basically you can do whatever. You can do it with your fingers or with your mouse manually. Or you can do it with the align key. That's all up to you. Let's take our dimmers as the last thing. And when we have positioned them, we can start working on storing some groups in the window as well. Let's store some groups into the view as well. And as you remember before, we said all our vipers and then we said assign like this. Now we're going to do it a little bit different. We're going to say assign all our vipers, and you can say assign group one, and we can simply just push a button up here and it assigns all our vipers. This is the group containing all our fixtures. So if we go out of the setup menu and we push this one, it selects all our vipers because it's the same group as you have down here. You simply move the reference up here. So into setup again, maybe we should just clear out here and say, okay, this is a little small. We need it to be a little bit bigger. You have the width and the height right here. So you can basically just say 100 in the width. Ah, maybe that's too big. Maybe it's 75. And then the height is 75 as well. Then we have another square, but it's a little bit bigger than the fixtures themselves. Let's do the same for the Magoras. We assign this one up here. We can do the same with the atomics. We assign it up here. And all our dimmers, we assign them right here. Let's do the same for the width and the height. Let's set them to 75 in width and 75 in height to make them the same kind of same size of the other groups. So right now we need to space it maybe a little bit down so we get some more space. That's the beauty, another beauty of the layout view. You can set it up exactly the way you want it. If you need more space, if you need to cram everything together because you are working on a large rig, it's all up to you. So now we are almost here. Let's just make sure they are all straight. There we go. There we go. So right now we have all our vipers, all our auras, all our atomics and all our dimmers. And if we push them out of setup menu, push them, you can see it selects all the fixtures, which is brilliant. Now you can basically build any group you want. You can, in your dimmers, you can say, okay, you can build a group for the first two or the next three or whatever. On your vipers, you could do an odd group, an even group, the left fixtures, the right fixtures. That's all up to you. And whatever makes your world easier, whatever makes your programming easier, you should do. Lastly, let's make some different colors for these groups over here. Let's go back into the setup menu. Let's clear out of the selection. Let's choose all our vipers with right clicking. You go into the menu like this. You have the appearance tab right here. We need to select something different. And we have the options of choosing some different colors. I think I'll choose the red one for all the vipers. And you see it instantly changes to red. Now it's much easier to distinguish them from each other. Let's do the same for the auras. We pick the blue color. Let's do the same for the atomics. We can pick the green color. And let's do the same for the dimmers. We can choose the cyan color. So now we built an easy layout view. It didn't take long, even with explanation. So without any talking, you can do this in 3 or 4 or 5 minutes. You should do this every time you come out with a new rig, because it makes it a lot easier to work with afterwards. Right now, all this is stored into our default view up here. But we need to copy this a few times if you need to separate it in different views. Say we want a view where we only have all our vipers, for instance. I mean, this is not really important on a small rig like this, but if you're working on larger shows, you definitely need this. So if you take the default up here and you simply swipe down and you say copy and you put it down here. Now we copied it down here. Still the default, we can say we can rename it with using our swipeys. We can say wipers. And we can simply go in here, select all of these ones. Say delete and then select all these ones and they're gone. We have the default view up here with all of it and we can select here with only our vipers. Let's do that again. We copy this one like this and we place it down here. Oops. We rename it to Aura. There we go. And we simply delete all the vipers and all the atomics and all the dimmers. And so on and so forth. This is how it works. So we have the default view with all of it. We have the vipers. We have the auras. Let's copy the default view down here. Oops, wrong button. Let's copy this one down here and call it atomics. And let's do the same up here. Let's copy this one down here. And we can call this dimmer. There we go. Let's go to the atomics and we can delete all our vipers, auras, and dimmers like this. And we can go into dimmer and we can delete basically everything else but the dimmers. This gives you an advantage when you are working the larger shows. You can simply select, I know I need to work with my vipers, just clear everything else out. And now it's only the vipers up on the screen. You can still change this. I mean, you have the default view now. You have it in the center and it fills out almost the entire screen, which is fine. You can go into the vipers and say, okay, now I have a little bit more room. Maybe I need to position it differently, or maybe I need to make these bigger. So you can do this and say, okay, now there's a room for them to be 100 high and 100 wide like this, if you want to. This gives you a little bit more detail. You can move it around like you want to. It's all up to you how you want it. But this is basically the layout view, how it works. It's really, really simple to work with, and it's a great tool for working on larger shows. The last thing I wanted to show you was simply that the layout view gives you some feedback when you work with it. If you go out of setup menu and you choose all your vipers and you say at full, you see they instantly change to a open white. And if you go into my first view here and you choose magenta or magenta and you go back, you can see they also change color into magenta. So having the layout view open when you program actually helps you a lot, because you can always see the level of the light, you can always see the color, you can see if there's an effect running or something like that. So it's really, really, really powerful. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you'll give it a like, and I definitely hope to see you next time on this channel. So thank you very much for watching all the way to the end. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.